All right, live right now for your strength conditioning workout. This is Mel Ocampo from the Dover YMCA. All right, before you get started, we're gonna need some equipment for your workout. For today, you're just gonna need one dumbbell. If you are new to strength and conditioning or metabolic conditioning workouts, you want a dumbbell that's closer to light and medium weight. And if you've been doing this a while or you wanna push yourself a little bit more, you can go to medium or heavy dumbbells. All right, you're also gonna need a mat or a carpeted area if you want to do your push-ups or your crunches or your core work in a softer area. All right, so what is the focus for today for your strength and conditioning workout? The focus for today are two things. You've got compound moves and you also have movements where we're gonna work one side at a time and then the other. What this does is we're gonna work smarter rather than harder. We've got 10 exercises. Each exercise is gonna be done for 40 seconds of work and then 20 seconds of rest. We're gonna repeat those 10 exercises for 3 whole rounds and taking a minute rest before we start each round. So again, we're gonna work smarter, not harder, pushing your heart rate to its max for a set amount of time and then taking that recovery. Now, if you're new to the workout or new to metabolic conditioning workouts, no worries, we're gonna provide options and choices for you to follow. Anytime you need that drink, go ahead, grab some water, take that break. This is your workout and do what's best for you. All right, so let's see how many more people can hop on. And let's see, what time is it? All right, it's 10:30. So that means let's start your workout right now. I'm gonna get the music on, start the timer, and get your equipment. All right, so we're gonna start with a warm-up first, priming up our muscles, getting our body ready for the workout ahead. We're gonna start 8 squats. 8, 7, 6. You've got 4 more. Hips back and down, lift the chest. Next move, biceps by the ears. Drop and lift. So this time we're adding the upper body. And if that's too much, your hands can be beside or behind your head. And again, just lifting that heart rate up, lift the chest, push the hips back and down, and soften the knees as you stand up. All right, next move, right leg steps back, left leg steps back. So we're doing a back stepping lunge or a reverse lunge. We drop the back knee down, bend the knees at 90 degrees, lift the chest and tighten your core. Couple more. We're gonna be doing this a lot at our workout. That's why we just wanna prime the quads, work on ankle stability as well. All right, we're gonna open up to the right and then to the left. Again, warming up the lower back, warming up the thoracic spine and lifting that chest. Couple more. All right, 90 degree, we're gonna reach up, reach. We're gonna be pressing overhead for the workout. So we wanna really make sure our shoulders are mobile. We've got that long spine, biceps come by the ears, and the core is engaged to support the lower back. Couple more. Arm circles, forward 8 times. 5, 6, 7, 8, and then going the other direction as well. All right, this time we're gonna have an easy jog just to slowly lift the heart rate up. All
three, two, we're gonna shuffle to the right. Shuffle to the right, easy jog here. Now shuffle to the left, easy jog here. Shuffle to the right, easy jog. If you feel like going to the low impact, do a low squat, march in place, switch sides. Couple more. Last one. All right, jacks, down and up. So arms go overhead, bend the knees and set your heels down. If you prefer loosening the impact, you can always tap, arms come overhead, or jab in front. Couple more here. Four, three, two, high knees. Now this high knees, your arms can be right up here, or you can add a twist to lift that heart rate up even more. Four, three, two, and one. All right, catch your breath real quick. Grab a drink of water. That was your warm up. Now time to get into your workout. Forgot to put my mind zone. So if you forgot to put your mind zone like me, you've got time to do it right now. I want this workout to count. All right. So we're gonna hear that beep in just a little bit. I've got my mind zone on. I'm gonna make this workout count and I'm gonna see how hard I'm gonna push myself to get into that yellow and red zone and then even see how fast I can recover to go to the green and blue zone. All right, so I'm gonna start my timer. Your first workout, you're gonna get your dumbbell. It's a single arm dumbbell swing, all right? We're gonna work 20 seconds one side, 20 seconds the other. You guys ready? All right, timer's gonna go. All right, here we go. Swing the dumbbell. All right, in your dumbbell swings, you wanna bend your knees, tip from the hip, and thrust the hips forward. As you do that, you're turning on your glutes by squeezing your butt. Soft bend in the elbows, and your arm just goes up to your shoulder level. Switch sides, 20 seconds, other side. And again, you wanna thrust those hips forward. You rock your way to the back heel and hips thrust forward. Come on guys, 10 seconds. And done. All right, next move is a single arm squat press. Come to your right hand, drop and press up. 10 seconds to rest. Here we go. Squat press, right side, push, drop, and push. You come into squat, bend knees, drive the bar or the dumbbell over the head. Your other arm's out for balance, or it can be by your side. Soften the knees as you stand up. Keep that core tight. Halfway, switch sides, left, drop, and push. This is a powerful movement. But right now, you want to ace that technique. 10 seconds. Hold. All right, next move, reverse lunge with a high pull. You're gonna take your right leg, step back, step in, high pull. Step back, step in, pull, all right? Hold on. Two, go. Step back, step in, pull. Step back, in, pull. Definitely go in your own pace. When you step back in your reverse lunge, bend the knees at 90 degrees, knee in line with the ankle, and lift that chest up. All right, you're gonna switch sides pretty soon. Go. When you do your high pull, your elbow just goes into that shoulder level. The dumbbell right by your collarbone, right? Keep the chest lifted and pull. Three, hold, rest, next. It's a burpee, and then you jump over that dumbbell, all right? Core engaged in your plank. Hop over or jump over. 10 seconds for rest. Go, burpee, jump over. Now your chest can come all the way to the ground, or they can come in plank. Another alternative is you hop over, drop squat, hop over, drop squat. Or you can also step back in, and come over. Keep going, 20 seconds. Push that heart rate up. Come on. Rest. Next, you're gonna do a push-up with a renegade throw, starting with your right side. All right, on your knees or toes, push-up position. Hands shoulder-width apart, knees hip-width apart, a little bit wider. You drop down, you pull up. Ready? Go. Drop down, pull up. Drop down, pull up. Now, if your weight is too heavy, B, here's an alternative. Drop, reach. Drop, reach. All right, drop your chest to that 90 degree level, chest to elbow level, push up. Switch sides, knees or toes. How are you guys doing? Yeah. only knees or toes. When the buzzer hits, you're gonna open up to one side and close it in. All right, here we go. Now you can do this on your knees or squeeze the butt and open up as one to the right side. When you open up, shoulders stack on top of each other, hips stack on top of each other, and pull that hip up. Halfway, turn to the other side. That's it, you guys, 10 seconds. Then we've got one more. Rest. Your next move, you're just gonna hold in plank for 40 seconds, all right? 10 seconds, rest. All right, hover position. Let's go, knees or toes. You wanna drop your hips. You don't want the hips here. Drop it down so your core is ignited right now. Press down the mat through the forearms. Activating your shoulders and your triceps. Halfway, you guys. I am shaking throughout my body. Yeah, the longest 10 seconds ever. Rest. All right, you've got 1 minute rest. So here's how you want to think about it. We've got three rounds. Your first round is about technique, just learning the moves, getting used to it. Second round, that's when your mind and body starts connecting. So you can push yourself a little bit harder, go faster, or even pick up a heavier weight if it is available. All right, so now we're getting into the second round. Remember, the moves get more acquainted to your body, so you can push yourself a little bit more. All right, we got 20 to 15 seconds of time. Grab a drink if you need to. All right, your next one, from the top, single arm dumbbell swing. Let's go, tip from the hip, bend the knees and swing. If you have a kettlebell, this is gonna be like a kettlebell swing. Just a different dynamic with your forearm as you use the dumbbell. All right, switch sides. And again, the power comes from your glute and core. How much control can you do as you thrust your hips forward? Yeah. Rest, 20 second rest. Next move, single arm press. Enjoy the 20 seconds, guys. Second round. Pushing a little bit harder. Drop and press. Drop and drive. Come on. You want to drive the palms of the hand up to the ceiling. Sink down into your heels, and as you drive up, power comes from the glute and the arm just follows through. Switch sides. Now my other arm is up for balance. You can definitely put it to the side, but having it out here helps me balance even better. Yeah. How low can you go and how high can you drive? Yeah. 20 second rest. Next move, reverse lunge with a high pull. Right side first. The heartbeat. I hope you're in yellow. Drop down, pull up, drop, pull. Now if this is your second round, go ahead. Maybe have speed, or maybe this time, press your front heel a little bit more to ignite your glutes, right? Drop, press, and lift. Switch sides. Press through that front heel and pull up. Yeah. Remember, compound movements, working smarter, making the most out of your time. Yeah. All right, burpee over that dumbbell. How will you push your burpee to that next level? 10 seconds to think about it. Three. Go. Now, if you want to push yourself a little bit more, add a tuck over that burpee. All right? But again, we've got choices available for you. A squat and a hop over. It's not how hard you push. It's how smart you push. So make sure you're using the proper technique to use the proper muscles. Let's go! Ah. 10 seconds. Come on, this is where you push all that you have. You might be in the yellow, you might be in the red. Wherever you are, you got this, guys. Next move, a push-up with a renegade row. Knees or toes. Down and push. Down and push. Again, your alternative. Down and reach. Down and reach. And if you're brave, on your toes. Halfway. Now your arms are probably fatigued at this point. So you're gonna press the palm of the hand down that mat to exact your shoulders and your triceps. Come on, press it down, then pull. Single leg deadlift with a bicep curl. You're halfway, literally. No time to think. Single leg deadlift, high pull. Bicep curl. Single leg deadlift, bicep curl. Again, this is for ankle stability. How is your ankle and your glutes gonna keep you stable? Answer, use proper form. Use the core, squeeze the butt. And as you suck in the core, the whole body is isolated. Yeah. Surrenders, you guys. It's a down, down, up, up. Remember, you can do this with or without your weights. Get ready. Knees come down, down. Down, down, tricep extension. Up, up, down, and lift. Down, down. If you were just hopping in, the modification for this is hands behind your head, where you can go down, down, and up, up. It's all about core stability to keep your chest upright. Sit, you guys. Crunches, next three moves, all about your core. Ten seconds till your next move. All right, let's crunch it up. Peel that shoulder blade off that mat. Maybe this time, reach higher, you guys. Reach it higher. Yeah. 20 seconds. Seconds never felt so long. All right, rotating hover, swinging on each side. Genie arms, stack it on top of each other. Knees hip width apart or a little bit wider. Here we go. Open, open, down, down. Now, as you open up, you want your body opening up as one. All right, that means shoulders stack and hips stack on top of each other. Switch sides, turn to the other side.
Technique. You've made the connection between your mind and your body. Last round, all about pushing it to that next level, right? How much can you work, or how hard or smart can you work in the next 10 minutes? Halfway there. Grab a drink if you need to. Who's with me? Last round. You got 10 seconds. We're gonna start from the top. Single arm, dumbbell swing. How much power can your hips make so you feel that push as you swing your dumbbell? Come on, last round, all you got. Switch sides. Momentum and strength comes from the drop and the power of your hips. 10 seconds, you guys. This is the last time I'll be doing this. Next move, single arm squat press, right side. Hold. Drop, drive, drop, drive, come on! You want to punch your heart rate to that yellow and red zone. You got this. Switch sides. All you got? Reverse lunge with a high pull.
No words, just movement. Right leg, step back, high pull. Now I know you're fatigued, keep going. But here's the thing, how much control can you put even if your muscles are fatigued, all right? All about the core, all about the glutes. Everything follows through. Switch sides. How much movement can you do in the last 3 seconds? Burpee over the dumbbell. This is your halfway peak point. So give it all you got, whether you're squatting down, whether you're jumping. Last time for burpees. Let's go. Soften the knees when you that land. hovers. Second to the last move. My arms are jello. How about you? All right, hover position. Open up to one side. Remember, even if you're fatigued, form is still important. So if it helps, drop that one knee down. Everything opens up as one. Switch sides. One last. Hover. For 40 seconds. Your last workout. Stability through core strength. You guys got this. Come on. Lengthen your neck. Press down the forearm into the mat. And squeeze your glutes real tight, guys. I'm feeling the shakes. Yeah. Come on, stick with it. That's it. Two. Done. Done, done, done. Down real quick. Take your right leg, bring it in front, push the hips forward, big inhale, opposite arm reaches over to stretch out your hip flexors. As you exhale, knee in comes to 90 degrees, big inhale, twist towards the front knee. Let's loosen up that back. Square the hips here. Inhale, push the hips back. Stretch out your hamstrings. You can hold onto your thigh or all the way down to the mat. If you're wearing your fitness trackers or your MyZone, comment below, what was your peak heart rate? Come on, let's get those yellow points. Let's get those red points, right? Again, other side, big inhale. Push the hips forward. Reset to the center. Big inhale, you're gonna twist towards your front leg. Square the hips, push the hips back. Hands onto the thigh or onto the mat. All right, bring that back leg in. All right, sink down to the heel. That way you can stretch out your calves. Switch sides. Slowly roll up. All right, take your right arm. Bring it over the head. We did a lot of arms today, right? Compound movements, working smarter. Not harder. Switch sides. And the nice thing about isolating one side at a time is you get to focus on the strength of one versus the other. Right arm across your chest. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Open up wide. Switch sides. All right, let's end with your breath resetting down the center. Big inhale, arms come overhead. One more time. You guys rock. Tuesday, strength and conditioning, 10:30 a.m. Check out the other classes for more workouts to come. Have a good day. Bye.